In this problem, we're given two 330 microfarad capacitors, and we're told we have a battery pack producing 4.5 volts potential difference. In part A, we're asked to connect these capacitors in a way that maximizes the charge stored on the capacitors. This is going to happen when the capacitors are connected in parallel, because when they're connected in parallel, the equivalent capacitance is simply given by the sum of the two capacitances. And I'll post a link to the video where that was first derived. So to show the circuit diagram that maximizes the stored charge, we just show a circuit diagram for two capacitors in parallel. So there it is, two 330 microfarad capacitors connected in parallel. Again, those capacitances simply add, and we get an equivalent capacitance of 660 microfarads. And now we can compute the charge stored on this equivalent capacitance of 660 microfarads. We can go back to the formula for the definition of capacitance, that's the charge per volt, and just solve that for the charge, and I get Q equals CV. We plug in the capacitance of 660 microfarads. We have a potential difference of 4.5 volts. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 2,970 microcoulombs. So we allowed that factor of 10 to the negative 6, that micro, to be a spectator, and I just multiplied 660 times 4.5. Now, a better idea would be to shift the decimal place 3 times and call this 2.97 millicoulombs. In part B, we want to make a circuit diagram showing how to arrange these capacitors to minimize the stored charge. And what we're going to do is take a series combination, because in a series combination, I end up with 1 over the equivalent capacitance is 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2. And this is guaranteed to produce an equivalent capacitance that's less than either one of the individual capacitors. So there's a reasonable diagram of this circuit. And then we have to do the calculation. 1 over the equivalent capacitance is going to be 1 over 330 plus another 1 over 330. And that's just 2 over 330. And when I take the reciprocal of this, I get 330 over 2. And that's 165 microfarads. In other words, 1/2 the value of either one of the individual capacitors. Now we do basically the same thing we did before. I'm going to write down that Q is equal to CV in order to compute the charge stored on this equivalent capacitance. My equivalent capacitance was 165 microfarads. My potential difference is 4.5 volts. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 742.5 microcoulombs. Again, we might want to express that in terms of millicoulombs instead. I'm going to round to 3 sig figs as I go, so I'm going to call it 0.743 millicoulombs. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.